Hi everyone, it's Asia here, Lemon Creation, and today I would like to show you how to add paints and embossing papers to the tracing paper.
And I'm Amelie and I will help my mom.
I'm working in my small art journal and this page already had some paint on it. It's a Blazing Black from Lindy's. I was working with it on another project and I had some leftovers, so I added to the empty page. And I'm gonna be using two blues, Ocean Breeze Blue and Tilt-A-Wheel Teal. And this time, exceptionally, will cover almost all the page entirely. I don't usually do that, I love my white negative space. This project will be a tiny bit different and I'm doing it for a Lindy's August challenge. You've just seen the picture there with the color board. And I've sprayed the page firstly with water and the black paint went into reaction with water because it's not a permanent paint, permanent spray, but the reaction was quite small and I can add some more blue paint and it doesn't bother me the fact that the paint is running a little bit. The excess of the water or the paint I am dabbing off with the tissue and I'm drying it as I go. The reason for adding the stone there, it was just simply to tilt the page so the paint flows a little bit to the outside of the page as opposed to the crease of the art journal. Next step is to add Magical Ocean Breeze Blue and you could spray the page again with water and then sprinkle Magical and then either spray it again with water to move the powder more freely or just leave it as it is. But you can also do what I'm doing right now, so just mix the powder with water on the side and like that you will get uniform color. Because, as I mentioned already in my previous videos, Magicals are just a mixture of different colors. So when you add water to them straight on the paper, you may get some surprises with a tiny bit of other colors seeping through. And just for the fun of it and just to change the technique a little bit, with this blue I just sprayed it or made it splatter all over the page. And I didn't like the fact that in the middle there was no black addition, so I'm doing it right now. That's how I did the other three edges. And thanks to that the page will be more coherent to me. So now I'm gonna be working on the tracing paper. I think it's the thinnest tracing paper there is. And I'm gonna be adding Plumeria Pink Flat Fabio from Lindy's Gang. And I know that there are other tracing papers which are more thicker, but I use this one. So the whole idea is to dab the brush into the paint and remove the excess and just with a tiny bit of paint, paint over the paper. And as you can see, there is already some warping. There is gonna be even more, even though I'm trying really hard not to use too much paint. Too much paint equals more water, so that equals warping on the very, very thin tracing paper. I was afraid that my idea is not gonna work because I want to do some stamping on this paper later. And when the paper is very warped, the stamping is not gonna be clear, obviously.
But that will add a little bit of extra edge to the project.
I am using Holland Create stamp number 206 and I'm using my Misty to stamp it well. It's very tricky to stamp it onto art journal page. And with the stamps from Holland Create, the first time the impression is not great, and it's advised to leave actually a little bit of archival ink onto the stamp when you put it back in your folders, and just leave it like that. They will soak the archival ink and they will stamp later much better. And I'm gonna be using also embossed pen by Ranger. To do what, Amelie?
To do some white embossing.
Embossing. And that will also help me to cover the places where the stamp was not stamped clearly enough.
This is pearly white embossing powder from Mom's favorite Lindesgang.
And now I am back to my tracing paper and I will add some dots, some embossed dots with Joy stamp. This stamp is called Grunge Dots and embossed clear ink pad by Ranger. So basically I'll do it randomly. I'll just add randomly the embossing ink and I'll stamp it also randomly onto the tracing paper and then I'll dry it. But while drying, I have to be careful to move my heat gun all over the place so I don't burn the paper.
Now my mommy will use Misty to stamp a few times the flower on the tracing paper.
And my tip for you guys, if you have a archival ink or any type of other permanent ink on your machine or on your craft mat, you can use it antibacterial cleaner to remove it. And those are the flowers I cut out. I cut three of the flowers and I'm gonna be attaching them. So I'll make layers with three flowers attached together in the middle
with tacky glue.
I am gonna cut off the stem and as a stem I'm gonna use a piece of wire. And firstly I'm gonna coil it around the top of the stem and then I'm gonna cut the stem and glue the wire with a tacky glue.
To adhere the flowers to the page, the best is to use double-sided tape.
With the glue you may get some extra warping, which is not necessarily needed in this case. While I was stamping the flower on the tracing paper, I also stamped a part of the stamp. So I cut out three hexagons and I decided to place them onto the page. And because the hexagons are see-through, I cannot in this case use the double-sided tape. So I am using a glue, but I pay attention to add glue to all the part of the hexagon. So like that when it's dry, the surface is even.
This sentiment is part of the same stamp and it was stamped on a cardstock. Adding some splatter with frozen Jack Frost. My mom cannot live without splatters.
It's not true. Okay, so true. Guilty as charged. I hope you enjoyed this small tutorial with me.
And Amelie.
And I hope to see you soon in my next video. Don't forget to hit the bell button to get notified about my upcoming videos, which is just beside the subscribe button, so please hit this one as well. Have a lovely day and see you soon. Bye!
Bye!